The Nazgul have surely tracked us here.
They will find more than they bargained for. Clean wounds, and they never unsheathe their weapons. This looks like Eltariel's work.
Well, she is indiscriminate. By the look of it, some of these would have made good followers.
We must find her before she eliminates all our potential recruits. Though if she did, we'd have little need of an army.
If you were looking for Ringwraiths, you're too late. But before I engaged him, he was speaking to an orc who was different than the others.
There are worms nearby. Perhaps they can tell us what is going on.
If we take them alive.
You don't decide whom I let live, Ringmaker. You'd both do well to remember that.
That's Elfkill moves quick. What? Did you hear
that? Your war is
Do we understand what your experience is?
Nazgul have dealings with special orcs. What are they?
They're called the Chosen! I don't know what they're chosen for!
Look, down below!
What is the purpose of the Chosen?
Secure the hide here. It's something to do with the Seeing Stone. That's all I know!
What have the Hydea revealed?
Only the Shriekers know. The Chosen kill anyone else who gets close.
Chosen, where do they come from?
The Shriekers make them in some kind of ritual. All very secret. I don't know where.
I've got you now. I'm gonna kill you.
So long as the Witch King has the Palantir, any towers the Chosen hold will be his eyes.
Then we must blind them.
I see a rat! Death! Oh, no. An intruder! Get down here now!
The ritual to create the Chosen. Where is it performed?
No one knows. When a captain's selected, the Shriekers send a worm to tell him where to go.
We must tell Eltariel what we know.
This need not concern her. We have our mission and she has hers.
Her mission is the destruction of the enemy that tracks us. The more information we share, the better.
You keep that old dagger. It's my dagger.
Witch King is using the Hydea to track the ring.
They extend the Palantir's reach. Orcs called the Chosen guard them.
And the enemy may hold the Palantir, but the Hydea themselves are vulnerable.
So, we made a design.
And now we dismantle it.
Thank you. Solve with fire, and you're not one of them.
Scoff.
Edregitha.
Ready to die!
to become cheap.
My first drill instructor told me, trust in your training, not your armor. Even a finely wrought plate can buckle under a hard enough blow, but a skilled warrior can evade that blow so it never lands in the first place. Now Minas Ithil has buckled under. Some blows are impossible to evade, so we do the next best thing. Stand back up again, wounded as we are.
This armor is intended to be ceremonial, yet it seems sturdy enough.
As it should be. Gondor has little need for ceremony of late.
Gondor's roots are literal ones, for our realm is intertwined with the White Tree, our greatest symbol and inspiration. Isildur himself gave our people the sapling that would grow into the White Tree, and it survived attacks from Sauron, plagues, and multiple transplants as Gondor's borders shifted in war. Today, the White Tree stands in our capital, Minas Tirith, though it will not blossom again until the king returns, as my father once said.
White Tree. Symbol of Gondor.
Your nation will need more than symbols to inspire it soon enough.
We Gondorians are a seafaring people. Though our ships ply the coastlines and rivers, rarely venturing into the open sea. Yet it was not always so. Our ancestors, the Numenoreans, and their elven allies sailed to other lands in ships like this model. Sailors even claim it's possible to sail so far into the ocean that land is too distant to see in any direction. Hard to imagine. So I suppose I'll have to see it for myself someday.
Did the elves truly sail in vessels such as these?
In the First Age, this would count among the most ordinary ships in our fleet.
Oh,
I better raise a beacon!
Didn't see that coming, eh?
League.
Thank you. so fearsome in the flesh. Rotting, fetid flesh, I might add.
Krug.
Is repulsed by you, perhaps because it remembers how you failed your wife and son at the Black Gate. And I remember too.
What?
answer to anyone after this. I'll soon be a captain.
I feel as though my life in Mordor has been much longer than any other I lived.
This is but a moment in time. I have been fighting this war for thousands of years.